In previous lecture, I already discussed partial order, a relation called partial order or poset if it is reflexive, antisymmetric and transitive. If A related to A, it is reflexive. If A related to B, B related to A, then A equals to B, it is antisymmetric. And if A related to B, B related to C, then A must be related to C is transitive. I already discussed what is reflexive, antisymmetric, transitive, just to go through previous lecture. I also discussed comparable. Two elements A and B in a poset S are comparable if either A is comparable to B or B is comparable to A. So when every two elements of a set are comparable, it's called as total ordering. Definition 3, it's about total ordering. If S is comparable, it's poset, and every two elements of S are comparable, S is called a total ordering or linear ordering set, also called as total order or a linear order. Also you can say a chain. If every two elements of a poset are comparable, then you can say it is a total order or linear order or chain. Now example 7, the poset Z less than equals to is total order because A less than equals to B or B less than equals to A. So every two elements of integers are comparable in the less than equals relation. Suppose you take 1, 2, 3, 4, just a small integer set, just 4 integers. Then 1 is less than 2, 2 is less than 3, 3 is less than 4. Even 1 is less than 3, 1 is less than 4. So any two elements you will take, there is a relation. They are comparable. So you can say this is a total order. Next, example 8, the poset Z plus division. Division is not total order because every two elements are not divisible. For example, 2 is not divisible by 3, 5 is not divisible by 7. So any two numbers are not divisible. If every two numbers are divisible, then it will be total order. As every two numbers are not divisible, we cannot compare by division relation, so it is not total order. Next, definition 4, it's about well-ordered set. So S is a well-ordered set if it is a poset such that it is total order and every non-empty subset of S has a least element. Suppose we'll take 1, 2, 3, 4. It is a poset, also total order in less than equals to relation. And if we'll take some subsets like 1 or 1, 2 or 1, 3, 4, any subset we consider, that should be total order and that should be at least one element. Next, lexicographic order. The lexicographic ordering less than on A1 Cartesian product A2 is defined by specifying one pair is less than a second pair. If the first entry of first pair is less than the first entry of second pair, or if it is equals to, then the second element of first pair should be less than second element of second pair. So by simple way, we can write A1, A2 will be lexicographic order of B1, B2 if either A1 is less than B1, or if A1 equals to B1, then A2 must be less than B2. So either A1 less than B1 or if A1 equals to B1, then A2 must be less than B2. Now an example of lexicographic ordering, example 9, determine whether 3-5 comparable to 4-8, whether 3-8 comparable to 4-5 and whether 4-9 comparable to 4-11 in the poset Z cross Z and relation is less than equals to. So we need to check this order pair whether they are comparable in the relation less than equals to. So first we'll check 3-5-4-8. So first element is 3 and 4. So we'll check 3 less than 4. Hence, these are comparable. Next, 3, 8, 4, 5. 3 is less than 4, hence it is lexicographic comparable. 3 is less than 4. This order pair 3, 8 is less than 4, 5. Next 4, 9, 4, 11. 4 equals to 4, but 9 is less than 11. Right? So 3 is less than 4, it follows that 3, 5 is comparable to 4, 8. And 3, 8 is comparable to 4, 5 by less than equals relation. And in case of 4, 9, 4, 11, first entries are same, 4 are same, but 9 is less than 11. So in today's lecture, I discussed what is total ordering, what is well ordering, and what is lexicographical ordering. In next lecture, I'll discuss hash diagram. If this lecture is helpful for you, please like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.